Hi there, my name is Dimitris Haralambidis, I'm a mathematics teacher, and in this video we are going to talk about the equations of vertical and horizontal asymptotes of a rational function. We will begin with some very useful definitions. Definition number one. What is a rational function? A rational function is a function written in the form f of x equals p of x over q of x, where both p of x and q of x, both numerator and denominator, are polynomials. Definition number two, degree of a polynomial. By degree of a polynomial, we mean the highest exponent that can be seen in that polynomial. For example, given the polynomial p of x equals 3x plus 5, its degree would be equal to 1, since the highest exponent that one can see here is number 1. Similarly, given the polynomial p of x equals 3x squared minus 5x plus 6, the degree in this case would be equal to 2, and in the polynomial 5x cubed minus x squared plus 4x minus 3, the degree would be equal to 3 respectively. Keep in mind that even any number can be considered as a polynomial, and more precisely, any number can be considered as polynomial of 0 degree. Third definition, highest degree term of a polynomial. The highest degree term of a polynomial is that term of the polynomial that contains the variable with the highest exponent. For example, in the polynomial 3x squared minus 5x plus 6, the highest exponent is the square. Thus, the highest degree term will be the term 3x squared. Similarly, in the polynomial negative 3x plus 7, the highest degree term will be the term that is equal to negative 3x, while in the polynomial 4x cubed minus 6x squared plus 10x minus 20, the highest degree term will be the term 4 times x cubed respectively. And now let's talk about the fourth definition, which is basically our topic, asymptote of a graph. By asymptote of a graph, we mean a line at which the graph tends infinitely close to, but never crosses. Considering our syllabus, we will be given a rational function and we will be asked to find the equations of the vertical and the horizontal asymptotes. Let us now see how exactly we will be doing that. We'll start with the vertical asymptote. A vertical asymptote will always be a perpendicular to the x-axis straight line written in the form x equals c, where c is a real number. To find the value of c, one must take the function's denominator, make it equal to 0, and simply solve for x. For example, given the rational function f of x equals 5 over x, here we can clearly see that the denominator is equal to x. Therefore, based on the methodology I just mentioned, we should create the equation x equals 0 and solve it. But here it's too obvious. The vertical asymptote will be the equation that has the line that has an equation x equals 0. Let's see some more examples. F of x equals 4 over x minus 8. Here, the denominator is the expression x minus 8. Therefore, to calculate the vertical asymptote, I will take this expression, make that equal to 0, and solve for x. Thus, I should get that x minus 8 equals 0, which means that x is equal to 8. And that's exactly the equation of the vertical asymptote. Example 3. F of x equals 3x plus 10, and all that over 2x minus 6. A quick note here would be that we don't care about the expression in the numerator. We simply care about the denominator. Therefore, the denominator here is equal to 2x minus 6. Once again, I will make that expression equal to 0 and solve for x. Thus, 2x minus 6 equals 0, which means that 2x is equal to 6, which means that x is equal to 3, and that's the equation of the vertical asymptote. Fourth example, f of x equals 7x minus 4 over x squared minus 1. I will begin by finding the denominator, which is the expression x squared minus 1, and now I will make that denominator equal to 0, and therefore, and from there, I will solve for x. Doing that, I would get that x squared minus 1 is equal to 0. Now, applying the difference of squares, I can rewrite that as x minus 1 times x plus 1 equals 0. Here we have the zero product rule, which says that a product is equal to 0 if at least one of its factors equals 0, which would lead to two different cases, x minus 1 equals 0 or x plus 1 equals 0. Solving each one of these two cases for x, I would get that x is equal to 1 or x is equal to negative 1. And what does this tell us about the vertical asymptotes? Well, basically, it denotes that we can have more than one vertical asymptote in a graph. Fifth example, f of x is equal to 5x over x squared plus 1. The denominator here is equal to x squared plus 1. Once again, I will make that equal to 0 and solve for x. X squared plus 1 is equal to 0 would mean that x squared is equal to negative 1, which is, of course, something that cannot happen. And what does this tell us this time? That in a graph, we can sometimes have no vertical asymptotes at all in a rational functions graph. Now that we have a clear image on how to work with the vertical asymptotes, let us move in the horizontal asymptotes. Let's begin by saying that a horizontal asymptote is a parallel to the x-axis straight line this time, written in the form y equals c, where c is a real number. To find the value of this real number c, we need to discriminate cases regarding the degrees of the functions numerator and denominator. More precisely, for a given rational function written in the form f of x equals p of x over q of x, we have three cases. Case number one, if the degree of p of x, the degree of the numerator, is smaller than the degree of qx, the degree of the denominator, then the horizontal asymptote will always be the line with equation y equals 0. In other words, the horizontal asymptote in this case will be the x-axis itself. Case number two. If the degree of the numerator, the degree of p of x, is bigger than the degree of the denominator, the degree of q of x, then there should be no horizontal asymptote. And last and third case, if both numerators and denominators have the same degree, if degree of p of x is equal to degree of q of x, then we have to take the highest terms of numerator and denominator and divide them. The result of this division will be the value c we needed. Let's work some examples. 1. Let a rational function f of x equals 4x minus 6 over 3x plus 8. As I mentioned before, all we need to do is find the degrees of numerator and denominator. Here, I can see that both of them have the same degree. Both the degree of numerator, the degree of 4x minus 6, and the degree of 3x plus 8 are equal to 1. This means that in order to find the horizontal asymptote, I should take the highest degree terms from both. The highest degree term from the numerator is the term 4x. The highest degree term from the denominator is the term 3x. And having these two highest degree terms, I simply need to divide them. The horizontal asymptote will be y equals 4x over 3x. And after some simplifications with the x's, I should get that the horizontal asymptote is the line with the equation y equals 4 over 3. Second example, let the rational function f of x equals 4x to the power of 5 plus 3x squared minus 6x plus 7 and all that over 3x minus 6. Here I can clearly see that the degree of the numerator is equal to 5 while the degree of the denominator is equal to 1. And this means that in this case there should be no horizontal asymptote. Third example, let the rational function f of x equals 4x squared minus 3x plus 6 and all that over negative 2x squared plus 4. Like in the first example, here as well both numerators and denominators have the same degree. This means that I should find the highest degree terms from both numerator and denominator and simply divide them. By doing that, I can easily find that the highest degree term of the numerator is the term 4x squared, while the highest degree term of the denominator is the term negative 2x squared. Their division will lead me to the equation y equals negative 2, which is the equation of the horizontal asymptote I was searching for. And one last example, let the rational function f of x equals 14x minus 6 and all that over 3x squared plus 8. Here, the degree of the numerator is equal to 1, while the degree of the denominator is equal to 2. This means that in this case, we are in case 1 from the ones we mentioned before, which leads to the fact that the horizontal asymptote will be the x-axis itself, will be the straight line with an equation y equals 0. And that would be all. For any questions you might have regarding the content we just viewed or any possible collaboration, you can always contact me. As always, thank you for your time.